Good afternoon. This is Dr. Bill White again and with the American Orthodontic Society, and I would like to discuss restoring a bruxism case. A good friend of mine, really, I treated his wife and his children, and he had ground his upper front teeth off of the centrals. Looked like there was less than a third of the teeth, maybe a little more than that, ground down the laterals, about half of them, and one cuspid was ground off a good bit. And he just was such a bruxer. I had a dental friend who went to high school with him, and he was a big football player, and said he was grinding his teeth when he was in high school, so he'd had plenty of time to grind them down over this period of time. And I will go in and show you this case. Let me see what's happening here. All right. The gentleman is a nice looking guy, you know, even though he ground his teeth off like that. When you look at him, when he smiles, I mean, the upper front teeth are just ground down terribly bad. In other words, when he smiles, it really shows up and looks terrible. So his wife and I think his kids, too, they twisted his arm to get him to come in and have his teeth worked on. Anyway, we got him in, and I want to show you these teeth. This will be a pretty short video. They're ground off. It looks like more than half of the upper centrals are gone, and you see the enamel is kind of hanging over the end. Once you get up that thick on the tooth, there's a lot of dentin in it, and it'll be ground off up inside of here, and then he would hit this or bump it, and the enamel chips, but it doesn't wear very much. So we wanted to get him restored, and he's got a closed bite too, so we're going to have to lower these anterior teeth, and so we'll have to put some stuff on the bottom, but he didn't want to do any orthodontics down there other than just we'll lower them down where we can build these down and give them a length, and the lower teeth will be down below. So that's basically what we'll be doing in the case. Let me go through and show you a few more views of it. This view right here is real good. It shows you the dentin just wore down, and you see it got down to where the pulp was. It receded and went away. It went on down further. And this is the most I've ever seen anybody just literally grind their teeth off like this right up on the front. There wasn't any acid reef, like I've had people that suck lemons that actually eat the tooth off like pretty bad. But this was just grinding the teeth together, or bruxism, and you can't really stop the bruxism. So we're going to try to restore it with something where his bottom teeth won't wear out over a long period of time. All right, we'll go ahead here. They can really see the thin enamel here. Enamel is hard as all get out, you know, and I'm an old man. I've eaten all kinds of hard foods and things with my teeth, and they have worn out. Enamel is tough, and it lasts a long time, but it has to have a base underneath it that gives and it holds it in there. But when the dentin is eaten away like that, leaves a shelf of enamel, then you can just bump the edge of this and you can fracture it off. It's kind of like, it's not as hard as glass, but it's a hard substance to have grown out of the body. And that's the way it is. Now, down on the bottom, we didn't do anything as far as the orthodontics here other than just lower these teeth down. And we worked off the molar teeth back here to lower these. And I want you to realize that when you lower one on one side, you raise one on the other side, and there'll be exactly the same pressure on either side of it. So the force to push these down here is coming from this tooth here, so it has a force of pushing it up, you see, and the same way on the other side. Just in the physics of it is this: you push one down, one of them has to go up, you see, on the other end of the line. Here's the models. We just took some snap models that are not pretty at all, but this was 1997, I think, there when we started it. Okay, let me go back, and I'm going to get back on those teeth again. We etched this whole tooth, you see, on the inside and the outside and all of this, and we put some liquid material that's the same chemistry as the light cured acrylic that was colored like a tooth, you had tooth color to it, and we put a big pad of that on these teeth all the way across here, and then we took something and shaped these teeth up. It was a little kind of a trowel like thing that we shaped the teeth up and made them look like regular teeth. They looked pretty good, really. And it took probably about 15 or 20 minutes for me to do that, to shape the teeth up. And we ended up with the teeth looking like that. Now, on the back side of these, we had extra material, and we had him close his teeth to a certain point, and the back teeth now are not touching. Back in here, the molars and bicuspids aren't touching. He only touches right up in here, and then we harden that material. So his mouth, after this, when he closes, only this touches, and nothing else touches until you get back here. The jaw joints take the load. So if your muscles bite together here, you got pressure in the front part of the mouth and pressure on the joints. And you have to learn that. Now, if you take somebody with a sore or sick joints that are inflamed, the tissue's inflamed and they're sore to touch like that, and you try to do this, they can't bite up here at all. Like, if you just run your lower teeth out, if you've got a good set here, like, I can bite my front teeth together, and nothing hits back here on either side, but I'm putting pressure. The pressure's up here on the joints on both sides. It's up here and here. And if you can't close anywhere else except to there, then you've got pressure here. Whenever you bite your teeth together, you're going to have pressure on the joint and the teeth. Now, people with a sick joint, in other words, joints that are inflamed, that are sore or anything, and you were trying to do this, you wouldn't have much success. If you get their joint healed up or get rid of the inflammation, then you can gradually do it. Now, you can go in and put a pad in the back of the mouth on the back tooth, and then let all the bicuspids and maybe the six-year molar come together. And when they get to where they hit, then when they close together, the load goes up through the cheeks in this area where it's strong, where it should be. Like if you're chewing something hard, you bite down on it, it goes this way. It doesn't go up here. But if you put your jaw out to the front to bite something off, bite a piece of meat or what, lettuce or whatever, and you try to bite something pretty hard. This is why nail biting is pretty bad, because if you have to bite pretty hard, that puts more force back here than you have up here. Your muscles are closer to the jaw joint up here than they are to the teeth out here. So if you bite with 5 pounds of force on your front teeth, you may have 15 or 20 pounds on the joint side, see? So this is something you have to take into consideration when you're thinking about fixing a person up where you're going to open their bite, you see. All right, we put this intruding wire on this molar back here, and when I'm pushing down on these teeth, this is going up with the same identical pressure that you're pushing down here. Then you'll be pushing, it's going to be half of it or a portion of the total of this pressure here, and here will be the same as the total pressure out here in the front of the mouth. And if you have the jaw brought forward, then this force that's coming up when they bite down, you've got the force out here, and then you've got the force up on the joint. It's going to be this, it's going to be greater back here than it is out here, because your muscles are closer to this than they are to this, the teeth out here in front. Now you may have to take a little while to digest that, and I didn't say it in a good, intelligent way, but that's what takes place when you do this. And so you need to understand how these forces work in the mouth. So anyway, we built these up. We couldn't just make them arbitrarily at a certain height. If you get them too long, then when the person is talking or moving their jaw, your teeth would fit together. And you learn that in making dentures, you know, fixing dentures, parcels, and things like that. So anyway, I think we added a little bit more to get some length to this, to these teeth. But that's what we went through. So we're lowering these teeth out here. These are coming up. And whatever this comes up back here, it'll be greater, and his distance between the chin and the nose is going to increase slightly. But you won't be able to notice it much because it doesn't increase very much. But it could be, if you had somebody who was really wide open to start with, you wouldn't want to do it that way. You'd want to put pads back in the back and work on it. I think we've gone over that before. Okay, so we had him fixed up like it's pretty good. So it worked out good, and I just shaped those teeth up, and then we took the light and hardened them. And he wore that for a week or two until it, you know, we were sure we didn't have them too long or had them look any good. And his smile line, everything was good. So his regular dentist sent him to a lab. That guy's a pretty sharp lab man. Now here is this was hard now. So he ate on this and his teeth didn't touch. But after, if you go like this for a month or two, your teeth will erupt, or they will move together where they come in contact back here. But of course he hadn't been in that long. Now you can take impressions of this, and what happened, his regular dentist cut his teeth, prepared them for crowns. In other words, he cut the teeth down, these five teeth, that this is a cusp in your lateral two centrals and a lateral over here. This cuspid wasn't Bruxer worn down hardly any, so they didn't crown it. And then he made this on there. He put the wax that he was going to wax these teeth up with in and closed these teeth together, you see. And that put his lower front teeth, made this indentation right here. So now he sections this off and he waxes a crown up. And this is a partial crown that he's going to bake porcelain on the top of that later. This is a complicated thing. I mean, it's a pretty well worked out now. All right, so now he fixes this up and makes some crowns and put a kind of a temporary thing on there at first, and then he made the final porcelain outer portion of the tooth. It looks like it's all porcelain, but there's a gold core in here with a gold shelf on the back where the lower teeth will meet. I won't show it to you with a picture from the inside in just a minute. We'll look on sides, and that's the teeth waxed up now. All right, on the inside, see, he made, this is that part that was touching back there, and he just sectioned this down, you see, and kept that, and then put the porcelain, baked it, and attached it. Actually, it's baked onto the gold portion of the tooth. Now, when he bites his jaw, when he brings his jaw forward to bite off anything, chews nails or whatever, his lower teeth would hit out here. But normally, his lower teeth close in here on this shell. So his bite can't deepen anymore. It'll come down and hits on that little shelf right there, which keeps this bite from deepening more. You know, when we first took that picture, the teeth were up close to the gum. Now they're down something like this. I don't know if you can see that, but maybe you can in that little picture on the side of this. Now they take that and we cemented those in, and I didn't do it. His dentist cemented those, and this worked out good. And he didn't do anything to the lower, other than the fact that we had actually lowered them down to give us some room to build those teeth up there. So here he is after he finished, and when he parts his lip, you can see teeth. We didn't see them before, but you'll see teeth now. And when he smiles, that's a little artificial smile, you know, it'd be better. But he's got a nice set of teeth, and he looks good. And maybe his wife is satisfied with the way he looks. He's a real nice guy. You'd enjoy meeting him, and I've enjoyed working on him. And I appreciate y'all looking at this. There's more to it than meets the eye here. So anyway, I'm going to close out. And thanks for watching. And I hope you'll subscribe to our channel. We would like to have you on there. So thanks again. And I'm going to close out here if I can get this deal over. So thanks again.